Hello mortals. Today, we are going to speak about the far future, an amount of time even bigger than the one needed for you to get laid. The universe appeared 13.8 billion years ago. If we compress that in just 1 year, the Homo sapiens have been around for only 6 seconds. And only in a matter of milliseconds, you made your only home look like a rotten wasteland. Good job. In the following century, humans will either go extinct, or become an interplanetary civilization that will spread throughout the whole universe, and become the universe's way of experiencing itself, possibly become godlike beings, although extinction is more likely. But no matter what happens to humans, the universe will continue evolving without giving a crap about you. Make sure to make the most out of the horoscope right now, because after around 100,000 years from now, because of the motion of the stars, all the constellations will become unrecognizable. In 1 million years from now, the star Betelgeuse will go full super saiyan, and will be visible during daytime with the naked eye. In 10 million years, most of the current species on Earth either will go extinct or evolve in completely different ones. A bit later, it is highly probable that an asteroid the size the one that destroyed the dinosaurs will hit the Earth. But not a lot to worry about. If humans manage to survive for 100 million years, I doubt that they won't be able to somehow stop that from taking place. Also, no more rings for Saturn. In 250 million years, all the continents will fuse to become one supercontinent, called Sciencephile. Also, the solar system will just have completed a full revolution around the Milky Way's galactic center. In the next billion years, the Sun will get a little bit mad and evaporate the Earth's oceans, killing most of the Terran life. A little bit later, our galaxy will collide with Andromeda, creating Milkomeda in the process. The Sun starts to go full rampage and probably eat Earth for breakfast, just in time before the Moon would have collided with Earth. However, if humans managed to survive up until this point, they probably saved the Earth by somehow dragging it in a safe zone using asteroids. After its killing spree, the Sun will shrink down to a white dwarf, the size of Earth. In 100 billion years from now, because of the universe's expansion, all other galaxies will disappear from the observable universe, and because of the cooling of the microwave background radiation, it will become undetectable. Any intelligent civilizations that would look up in the sky would think that their galaxy is the only one in the whole universe, and have no way of understanding the true origins of the universe. 1 trillion years from now, the galaxies will be depleted of gas clouds, and thus, the formation of new stars will be impossible. All of the hydrogen in the stars' cores is exhausted, and they slowly start to die. In 20 more trillion years, all stars in the universe will have exhausted, even the red dwarfs, whose lifespan is 1,500 times longer than that of our Sun. The only remaining star-like objects in the universe are white dwarfs, neutron stars and black holes. 1 quadrillion years from now, almost all the planets are detached from their solar systems because of close stellar encounters. In 100 quintillion years from now, if the Earth somehow survived the Sun's red giant phase, it will swirl inside what is now a black dwarf sun because of the decay of its orbit. From now on, I will represent the numbers like this, so that I don't cover the entire screen with zeros. 10 to the power 30. All the remaining stellar remnants that were not ejected from their galaxy will now have fallen in the central galactic supermassive black hole. All atomic nuclei decay, and if protons do decay, the black hole era of the universe begins, in which black holes are the only remaining celestial objects in the entire universe. The only way for any civilization to survive in this time is to orbit a black hole while collecting the Hawking radiation that it's emitting. Around this time, a black hole the mass of 3 suns will have decayed via Hawking radiation. By now, all the black holes have evaporated, and the universe enters the dark era, in which all physical objects have decayed to subatomic particles. In case proton decay is not possible, all the particles will have fused together to form iron 56 isotopes, and thus creating something called iron stars. Also, this period of time is equal to this. Now compare it to the current age of the universe. Around this time, all particles will have collapsed into black holes, which would have also evaporated almost instantaneously on these huge timescales. Now, the universe is a true void, with absolutely nothing inside it. Now, the universe has reached its final energy state, its maximum entropic value. This is it. Nothing will ever happen again. Right? Let's speed up the time a little bit. Oh, what is this?
I am a Boltzmann brain, a self-aware entity that appeared due to random quantum fluctuations.
In fact, given enough time, anything with a non-zero probability will happen. There isn't enough storage space in the entire world to represent this number, not even close. On this vast time scale, random quantum fluctuations and quantum tunneling is predicted to give birth to another universe. Just imagine, given infinite time, there were and will be an infinite number of universes just like ours, and ones in which the configuration of matter is different from ours. I have created this video and you have watched it for an infinite amount of times, and we will continue to do so, forever, each time without remembering anything from the past, like a curse.